Hi, I'm Mike, independent camera repair technician, and I'm starting fixyourcamera.org to show you the photo gear industry from a different point of view. No specs, no marketing BS. Talking about things you won't hear anywhere else. Welcome. Hi, another quick tip repair video, this time about nameplates. Some third-party lens manufacturers design their lenses in such a way that in order to disassemble them, you have to remove the nameplate. And these are most likely made of aluminum. Very soft metal, easy to scratch or bend, so it looks very unprofessional if you're not careful while removing them. Here I'll show you how to do it safely. So, before you start, you need sharp and strong tweezers. This is important. With poor quality tweezers, you're guaranteed to make scratches. Also, a tiny amount of isopropyl alcohol and optionally a label backing paper and x-acto knife or some other sharp blade. Put a couple drops of alcohol around the edges. Be careful not to flood this whole lens. It immediately goes around on its own. I hope you can see it here. Let's put some more. And now I'm gonna wait about 1 minute, maybe less. Once it dries up, it might leave a bit of white residue, but don't worry about this, it's easy to get rid of later. Although it is a good idea to test the alcohol on your particular lens model's nameplate to make sure it doesn't react in some weird way. This plate is held by a double-sided sticky tape, so the alcohol will make it slightly softer and then evaporate, leaving this tape perfectly intact. Let's add some more and wait again. I usually repeat this 2 or 3 times. Now, I insert the tip of my tweezer over here, between the edge of the nameplate and this plastic ring. The goal here is to do it in such a way that there are no marks left on either the plastic barrel or the nameplate itself. I start with one of the corners and pull it gently. I pull it very gently but with a steady force for like 15 or 20 seconds. It should come off easily. If it doesn't, don't force it. Reapply the alcohol 1 or 2 more times and try again. And it's loose now. So this is good. Let's go to the other side. Again, be very careful. Don't leave any marks or scratches. Again, I pull it gently, applying very little force for several seconds. Okay, and it's done. Actually, this one came off surprisingly easily. Maybe because it's a brand new lens. Usually it takes a bit more time to get it loose. It's in perfect shape and there are no kinds of marks on the nameplate or plastic edges around. It's perfectly fine. This is the double-sided sticky tape that's holding it. The alcohol will evaporate within a minute or so, and it's going to hold very well when I put it back in place after I'm done working with this lens. Now, same process for this plastic window. This one should come off even easier, but still I'm extremely careful with it. Because there is just no way I could logically explain to any of my customers why I left a nasty scratch on his focusing window. There is just no excuse. Even if I wanted to replace this part, there is still no way I could explain to my customer why he has to wait an additional week or two to get his lens back. For popular lenses, repair shops usually have many parts in stock, but this one is not so popular. Overall, what my customers often don't realize is that my job is mostly about being careful and not destroying stuff. The whole diagnosing, repair, and all other things come later. Okay, and it's out. So now I can work on this lens, disassemble it, fix the problem, put it back together. But before putting this plastic window and nameplate and all rubbers back, I always test it to make sure it works properly. And when I'm sure it does, then I can attach all of these things. You know, just in case I have to disassemble it again, I don't have to deal with all this annoying stuff. It would be just a waste of time. And now the optional part of this process. If you happen to bend this thin piece of aluminum, which might happen especially if you're doing it for the first time, you can put a piece of label backing paper to the back of it, carefully cut out the edges, The center part where the plastic window goes is not necessary, you don't have to do it. And while cutting, slide your knife over the bottom edge, not the top one. Then, with this paper attached, put it back in place and make sure it fits properly and none of the edges are sticking out. If it's not perfect, you can bend it gently with your fingers and check again. This way you can make sure it's gonna be absolutely perfect. I always make sure that the plastic window is clean and also that the focusing scale on the lens is clean. There's a little bit of extra space on both sides, so I try to center it. Otherwise, it would look weird. Quick clean and making sure it looks good. If there are any white spots from alcohol, you can use Windex, for example, and a piece of lens cleaning tissue to get rid of them. They'll be gone in a couple of seconds, but it's always a good idea to test it first. Make sure it's safe for this particular paint. Okay, so overall, if you take your time and do this whole process gently, you can do a much better job than some repair shops are doing. Trust me on this one. Another way to remove nameplates and this type of stuff is to use heat. Be careful though, because this plastic window will melt easily. So I think 60 Celsius degrees, maybe 70 would be the absolute maximum. But still, I think that alcohol is a much safer way to do it and probably easier and faster too. If you have some questions, please post them in the comments below. And subscribe to my YouTube channel for more photo gear, teardowns, reviews and repair tips. Thanks for watching and see you next time.